Blocking hackers is a big pain in the ass for WordPress sites. Why? Because WordPress is one of the most famous CMS platforms in the world. And for that reason, when a hacker wants to hack a site, the probabilities of it being a WordPress site are really high. And for that reason, they try to hack WordPress sites. So if you're on a WordPress site, you want to prevent this. And for that, I'm going to show you a way to prevent this using Cloudflare. And Cloudflare, I mean the free version. So you don't have to pay anything, but you're going to be able to block hackers from even reaching your hosting provider. So it's well worth using this. Now, before we jump into the actual rules and how this actually works, I want to show you my sponsor, which is Hostinger, which I have several sites here. And if you want to grab a Hostinger plan for your hosting, go ahead and go jump into hosting. And there's two really main products that I think that you should grab, which is web hosting, which is your shared hosting, and BPS hosting, which is what I use. If you grab a BPS hosting, you have several plans available depending on your needs. And if you want to grab one of these, for example, the most popular one, which is $7.99 a month, go ahead and add it to cart. And once you've added to cart, you have two options. You can select 1 month for $18.99, which is not such a great deal. But if you want to grab the $7.99 plan, grab the 12 months in advance. Plus the renewal price is much better, okay? But there's an extra discount coupon code that I want to show you. For example, it's $95.88. But if you have a coupon like the one I have here in the description, type in SaaS Master, apply it, and now it's going to be $86.29 for the year. And this is a BPS with really great limits, okay? So grab that. Now, let's jump over to Cloudflare for the actual setup. Now, for my particular site, which is a WordPress site, I have several of these, but if I go to a login page, for example, this is my WordPress site, okay? But if I want to jump into a login page, let me go ahead and type it in. Let's go to it. Here we go. Boom, it's been blocked. Even I don't have access to it because that's the way I set it up. Unless I white label my IP address, okay? Which I'll show you in a bit. So let's jump over to the rules. This is my particular site inside of Cloudflare. And even if you are on a Hostinger plan, hosting panel, you can still use Cloudflare as your DNS provider. This way you're preventing hackers from even reaching your hosting plan, okay? So right now, in the last 30 days, there's been, oh, this is for the traffic security, there's been 4,370 blocks in 30 days, okay? Top country that I've been trying to get hacked from is USA. Top threat type, bad browser, okay? There's the threat country, here you can see, threats, and you can see the more information there. But to set this up, jump over to the security tab here and you can view the events. Now, if you haven't set up the WAF rules, which I'm going to show you right now, you won't see events. Okay. These events means that it's been people, it's been blocking. Okay. For example, someone from India tried to reach this particular section of my website, which they have no business in that section of my website. So it's been automatically blocked. Someone who's surfing on a website is not going to those extensions. That's someone who wants to hack your site. Okay. So to block these people, go into WAF, and this is where we're going to set up our firewall rules. Now, on the free plan, you get up to 5 rules, okay? And it's more than enough, okay? Now, the first rule is dedicated to WordPress, okay? Let me click on this rule. And this rule, what it's doing is, if someone is going to this URL path, and if it contains this in the URL, it is going to get block. So this is the action. Okay. So if this happens, this is going to be the action. So in this case, I can block, I can do a managed challenge, a JS challenge, skip or interactive challenge. The most popular ones is blocked and managed challenge. Managed challenge is when you jump into the site and you see like a Cloudflare page before you actually jump into the site. It's just trying to prevent if it's someone potentially known as a hacker or someone who's suspicious, they will get the Cloudflare screen and they'll have to say, I'm not a robot, or they'll get blocked. Okay. But in this case, I'm doing a hard block. Why? Because even myself, I want to block myself. And if I want to reach the site, I'll whitelist my IP address. Okay. So what's happening? The URL path that contains wp-admin, it's getting blocked automatically. Okay. And if they're going to wp-login.php, if they're going to the xmlrpc.php, they are getting blocked. If they're going to these sections, they are getting blocked. Now, if you have a different login page, because that does happen when you're using a plugin or you just change the login page. So this is the one by default, but if you change it to something else, you can go ahead and add it also. I would still recommend that you add this page even if you have a different login page. Why? Because hackers are still gonna get blocked and it's not even gonna load a 404 page on your site. Cloudflare is gonna do the job for you. So what I'm gonna do is add or. So if this or this or this or this, it's gonna block, okay? So the next one is gonna be a URL path, here it is. And I could use equals, contains. So in my case, I use contains because it's more broader instead of being precise, okay? So I'm gonna use contains and I'm gonna say login is the other page that I've created. And again, I wanna block hackers from reaching that section, okay? So they don't even try to hack or try to use fake passwords or anything like that to hack my site because they are gonna get blocked from this section, okay? Now, if I wanna use a precise one, it'll be like this. Okay, so it has to be like this and I'll add that one. Let's go ahead and save it and it's been blocked. Okay, so let me go into my site. Let me go into the main page. Okay, here's the main page. I'm going to try I'm going to go to the path that says login blocked. Even if that is not a real login page or anything like that, it's still going to block it. But what if I type in something else from the end of that, go ahead and paste, and it just goes to another section of my site. So imagine that someone is trying to hack your site and they try to go to the admin login section of your site. It'll do this. So it's going to load your site, even if it's a hacker. So that's why I recommend that you still add the other rules from other pages that might be prone to be used as a login page. Okay. Now there's more rules. Let's go into WAF. And here we go. I've also added a threat score. That means that if someone is detected by Cloudflare as being threatening over 40, because it's the threat score greater than 40, it's gonna do a managed challenge. So they still have a chance to view my site, but they'll go through the Cloudflare screen and they'll have to go through the process of, I don't know, accepting or a puzzle or something like that to actually view my site. And what happens with this with a managed score, with a managed challenge? With a managed challenge, you get the challenge solve rate. So in this case, for this particular one, there's been 20 of these viewers that try to go to my site and they didn't solve anything. So that means 0% issues solved. So that means that if someone really wanted to go to your site, if it was a real user, they would go through the process of the Cloudflare screen, which is super simple, okay? And that's what happens with the threat score. Now, I've also created the HTTP version. So bots are prone to use 1.0 HTTP. So in this case, I'm doing a managed challenge. And as you can see, 20 of these users have been blocked. And this is in the, I think it's the last 24 hours. So in the last 24 hours, this is what's been happening, okay? And I've also added block suspicious query parameters, which sometimes I enable it and disable it because some plugins will try to reach these type of sections. And that's why I enable these. But go ahead and copy this WordPress rules if you wanna prevent hackers from reaching your site and add more if you need them, okay? If you know that there's other sections of your site that you know that need protection, go ahead and add them right here, okay? So those are the ones that I recommend to prevent hackers from reaching your site. So just like you see right here, someone from the United States with a custom role try to reach wp-login.php. Like I said, they have no reason to be there, okay? Because that wasn't me. And that means that they wanna hack my site, okay? So set up those rules. And don't forget that there's an extra discount coupon code on Hostinger if you wanna grab a plan. Remember, Shard Hosting and BPS are really great. Also, if you wanna grab the cloud hosting and Titan Business, if you're gonna do a lot of sending emails for email marketing, I do recommend that one also. And don't forget to use my coupon code that's available in the description. And that's a wrap for the WordPress rules to prevent hackers from reaching your site.